and welcome to Christmas week at PopCulture Reacts.
I should have decorated around us, shouldn't I? My bad.
And we are starting the week with some hippity hop and some old school hippity hop at that, with Run DMC and Christmas in the Hollis.
Some of the godfathers of hip hop, and not only some of the godfathers of hip hop, but one of my favourite Christmas songs, do bloody love it, and it's in Die Hard. I mean, yes. Pretty much this has got everything going for it, hasn't it?
Yep, and, you know, great sets of trainers, because they do love some white Adidas.
They bloody do, don't they? Not such a fan of shoelaces, though, which always felt like a health and safety risk to me. But
so, shall we get ourselves to New York?
Yeah! John McClane, this is for you.
Little up, where have you been?
Naughty, naughty.
Hey, that's right. Oh, the naughty you. Keeping me from my rounds. I'm late as it is. Now stay put. Don't go anywhere till I get back.
High production values back then.
Understand me?
Yeah. Nice.
Yo, man, let's go eat, man. I'm hungry. Starving.
Come on, man.
Ha 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 ha
Nice.
That's how you make a Christmas video with 5 quid.
At least a tenner.
Possibly,
the little boppet was probably a fiver on its own.
Yeah, and those reindeer's antlers that you put on that dog's head, they don't come cheap. So what do you think of Christmas in Hollis?
It is a staple of old school Christmas songs. I always enjoy some Run DMC. It's a Christmas song being Christmas songs, but not sort of doing that annoying thing that a lot of it does, where it's just samey as everything else.
Yeah.
This is, you know that this is Run DMC, and it fits with what Run DMC do.
Yeah, I think it's what I really like about it is obviously, it has the sleigh bells going all the way through it and things like that, but it feels like this is if Run DMC made a Christmas song. And I know that's really obvious, but as you said, sometimes you get artists who, they chucked a bag of cash and said, make a Christmas song, and they make the same Christmas song that everyone else did, whereas this feels like they kind of went, we need to get our sound into a Christmas song, and even integrating some of their sort of staple lyrics, but not just rapping normally with Christmas music in the background, leaning into that Christmas story. And it feels like they were having good fun. Now, probably the honest truth is this is probably more commercial than they wanted to be. However, they were just on fire at this point, and I think the record company must have been just like Santa in that, giving sacks of cash to them to kind of go, like, let's sell some records. But Always Stayed With Me is one that I really enjoy. The video is
of its
the video. Yeah. I mean, they didn't have a big budget clearly, and they thought they'd have a bit of fun. Thought it's really interesting though when they get the mistletoe out and they're all having a crack at his mum.
Yeah, it's a bit weird. Because I remember A Very Special Christmas, I think the album was called. Was like a Christmas album that came out in like the 80s. And this was on there. And it had like loads of weird people doing like Christmassy songs. And it's when I first heard it and I was like, oh, this is the one good one on this album.
Yeah, it does feel like a standout, doesn't it?
Yeah. Always Been There, Always is a classic.
And it's nice, isn't it? Because there are millions, that's probably an exaggeration, but there are hundreds of thousands probably at this point of Christmas songs. And a lot of them are very, very, very samey because I guess one's been popular and kind of formula. Whereas this was, as far as I know, kind of the first Christmas rap song and probably the first one that had any success to it. So it's nice to get another genre integrated into Christmas music.
Exactly. So we will be back with more festiveness.
For more musical presents for you to open on the road to Christmas Day.
Exactly. So until then, goodbye.